Good evening, students. I am Ganesh from the Department of Physics, Bharathidasan Matriculation Higher Secondary School, Arakkonam. We will continue with our discussion on moment of inertia and radius of gyration. So far we have seen about the moment of inertia, that it is the rotational analog of mass in a circular motion. Now, what if we have the radius of gyration? What is the radius of gyration? It is nothing but the point, which is an imaginary point, which connects the center of the axis of rotation, and it is a representative of the entire axis, which is imaginary axis passing through it. So you can call it as a parallel axis theorem in moment of inertia, parallel axis theorem. So what is the parallel axis theorem talking about? It states that the net amount of the object is having moment of inertia I is equal to, it is Ix plus mr square. So this is what it says. Ix is sometimes called as with reference to ICM, center of mass. So that remains us to tell us what is meant by center of mass. If the body is able to come back to its original equilibrium when it is disturbed in a circular object, then it is said to be having the center of mass situated within its base. So that is what is known as radius of gyration. We have defined as point situated on the imaginary line where the object is able to return back to original position. And so gyration means tending to move to and fro, and that is known as gyration. Next point. So we have seen the center of mass of an object being the representative point where the entire body is to be concentrated and within which the body will come to original equilibrium. So we will see the next point. Torque. Torque is defined as a twisting force. So if what is the difference between force and torque? Force is a linear one, whereas torque is a twisting force. So force is the force applied linearly, which is a push or pull linearly, which is a push or pull And in the case of torque, it is force into perpendicular distance. So this is also called as twisting force. What is the unit of torque? The unit of torque is nothing but Newton meter, the same, which is nothing but the work done, but it is in the perpendicular direction. I am going to show some simple problems to you, and I am going to let you understand the concept of moment of inertia. Which of the following quantity is directionless? So let us analyze one by one. In the case of moment of a momentum, so moment of a momentum means I am having a body, I am applying moment to it, it already turns, and I take one more moment, it once again turns. So that is having a direction. Moment of force, I am having a force acting, it is tending to change the direction of the body, this is the distance L. So F L is the moment of the force, it also got direction. Moment of charge, I am having a charge point Q, I am applying a force F. So the force tend to move the particle towards the clockwise direction. So it's also having direction. Whereas moment of inertia of a body does not have a direction. It is a mere quantity. It is mr square. So in this case, we have to take the value moment of inertia. All others have a direction. Next one, physical significance of mass in translational. Translational means linear motion is same as that of following in rotational motion. Angular momentum. Angular momentum is what? It is nothing but L. That's not the case. Torque, that's tau, not the case. Angular acceleration, alpha, not the case. These do not represent the mass, whereas moment of inertia represents the mass. So whatever is in translation motion, in rotational motion, it is nothing but I, which is moment of inertia, kilogram, meter square, moment of moment. So let us pass on to the next question. The moment of inertia of a body depends on what factors does the moment of inertia depend upon? It depends upon mass only? No. Angular velocity, first you calculate on mass only, it is not so. It depends upon angular velocity omega? No. Distribution of particles, so this is, but the last one is given as mass and distribution of body. So this answer is correct. So when you say moment of inertia of a body, it depends upon the distribution of the mass as well as the individual mass. The next problem we will see, the product of moment of inertia and angular acceleration. So in the place of m, I have substituted I. In the place of alpha, acceleration, I substituted alpha. I dot alpha is nothing but twisting force torque. So you should straight away take the answer torque. Very simple questions like this will come in neat. You can score 4 marks without giving a wink. Next point. Dimensions of torque. How will you calculate the dimensions of the torque? So you know very well that torque is the same analogy of force. So force and torque are both same. One is the push or pull, that is a force, push or pull, and this one is twisting force. So when you say it is the same, so when you say twisting force, you have to say that torque is nothing but tau is equal to I alpha. So what is tau? Moment of inertia is kilogram meter square, and this is radians per second square, or you can say it is equivalent to Newton meter. So this is how you have to analyze the value and look for the answer in the answer sheet instead of blindly taking whatever you know as correct. The next question is very simple. On applying a constant torque on a body, what happens? Linear velocity increases, we cannot say. Angular velocity may increase or decrease. Constant torque, so it is not a question of increasing or decreasing, that is not correct. It will rotate with constant angular velocity, that is correct. So answer is C. You have to check sure that you have the speed and you have the accuracy. Next problem is, the radius of gyration of a rotating body depends upon. So R, you know very well, it depends upon the shape of the body, volume of the body, mass of the body, applied torque. So let us consider one by one and check whether they are the same. Mass, rotating body have no question of dependence, it's wrong. Volume is also not right. Shape of the body, yes. Suppose the body is having a shape like this or it's having like this. In either case, the radius of gyration is going to change. So answer is shape of the body. Next one, let's see. Yes, an automobile engine develops 100 HP when rotating at a speed of 1800 radians per minute. The torque it delivers is. So very simple question. In this question, I am given that power is given as how much? 100 HP. And what is given? Omega is given as how much? 1800 radians per minute. So what do I have to do? I have to divide it by 1800 by 60 to consider it as equal to 30 radians per second. Now I have to calculate power in terms of watt. So power is equal to 100 into 746 watt. So if I divide it by 30, then I will get actually watt second. So it is around 1287 watt second. So that's the answer. It's a simple numerical. And last problem we'll see for the day before we call it. Yes, this is also a simple question. A torque of 2 Newton meter produces an angular acceleration of 2 radians per second square of a body. If the radius of gyration is 2 meter, then so what's given? Torque is given. Torque is given as 2 Newton per meter, Newton meter, and its acceleration is given as alpha is given as 2 radians per second square, and our radius of gyration is given as 2 meters. So you know that tau is equal to I alpha, correct? So I substitute the value, 2 is equal to I into 2 radians per second square. So I alpha is given as acceleration is 2. So I is equal to 1. If I is equal to 1 and the radius is how much? 2. So mr square is radius of I is equal to I. So r square is equal to how much? I is 1 and radius of gyration is 2. So m into 4 is equal to 1, or m is equal to 1 by 4 kg. So this is how you have to calculate. So I am very glad that you have been with me. I hope the session was interesting. You are having some doubts and you can clear it with me. Or you can send me through email and we will be in touch with you. Thank you.